Hello and welcome to our next video. Today we discuss little bit more further for the Fourier series. So today first I discuss the Dirichlet condition and what are the Dirichlet condition for continuous or discontinuous function. If we want to expand any function as Fourier series fx is equal to a 0 by 2 summation n going from 1 to infinity an cos nx bn sin nx, and where a0, an, bn are the constant of Fourier series which we have to involve with the help of Euler's theorem. Satisfy all these conditions. Number one, if fx is periodic, single valued and finite function. Second, fx has finite number of discontinuity in one period. There is with countable discontinuity. We cannot say that it is infinite discontinuity, so we can't able to find the Fourier series. So finite number of discontinuity. Third one, fx has finite number of maxima and minima at that point, then this function is convergence to fx. If convergence, then we can find out the Fourier series. Basically Dirichlet condition is the uniform convergence of Fourier series is called, what is this? This is convergence condition for Fourier series. Next we go for the Fourier series for discontinuous function. Discontinuous, if function is break at any point, then how we have to find out the Fourier series for that? So series is this. If our function fx is defined like if this is f1x and this is f2x for c to x to x0 point, and they are from x0 to x to c plus 2 pi. If our function is defined in two interval, function's value between c to x0 given by f1x and function value between x0 to c plus 2 pi, this interval function value given by f2x, then our Fourier series is this, and we have to find out a0, an, bn with different formula. We break that, means our, if our given function is this, if it is discontinuous, then this is the breaking point b and this is a. This point is x0. So our first function from here c point to x0, and second function is c plus 2 pi. If this is, then first function lies here. This is f1x, this is f2x, lies for x0 to c plus 2 pi. If function is discontinuous between particular time period 0 to 2 pi, then, or we can say c to c plus 2 pi, in 2 pi interval if it is discontinuous, then how we can find out the same like previous. Just what we can do, a0 is 1 by pi c to c plus 2 pi fx dx. So what we can do now, our function for up to x0 is f1x dx plus x0 to c plus 2 pi. Our function is f2x dx. So formula for a0 is this, means we have to break that integral c to c plus 2 pi fx dx in 2 part, and then we separately integrate. Similarly, same an is also 1 by a pi c to x0 f1x cos nx dx plus x0 to c plus 2 pi f2x cos nx dx. Similarly, what is our bn? Bn is 1 upon pi c to x0 f1x sin nx dx plus x0 to c to 2 pi f2x sin nx dx. So, we we have to break our integral in two limits and then we integrate like previous question. So this is the discontinuity. It may be discontinuous at 2 points, discontinuous at 3 points. So you can break this limit in entire portion. So if it is break in two portion, so c to x0, x0 to x1, x1 to 2pi. Similarly in all case. So now we discuss one example of this discontinuous function so you can better understand. It's same like previous. So we go for the example. Find the Fourier series for the fx equal to x and 2pi minus x for x going from 0 to pi and pi. This is pi to 2 pi. So our function break 0 to pi, value of function f1x is x, pi to 2 pi, value of function f2x is 2 pi minus x. Now we have to find out the Fourier series. When we go for the Fourier series, see, this is odd function x and 2 pi minus x, but if our range is given from minus l to plus l, or we can say minus pi to plus pi, in that case we can say this is odd function and we have to find out only bn a0 an is equal to 0. But when limit is 0 to 2 pi or c to c plus 2 pi, we have to find out all the values of a0, an and bn. So our Fourier series fx is equal to a0 by 2 plus a summation n going from 1 to infinity an cos nx bn sin nx. So first I derive an. So a0 is 1 by pi 0 to pi fx is x dx plus pi to 2 pi fx is 2 pi minus x, 2 pi minus x dx. Clear? When you integrate and put the limit, we will get pi is a0 equal to pi, our first value of the constant. Second, we go for an. Now we substitute here a0 equal to pi. Now go for an. An is 1 upon pi 0 to pi x cos nx dx plus pi to 2 pi, 2 pi our f2 is this cos nx dx. Clear? So now we have to integrate step by step, same integration by parts. X as it is, integration of cos nx is sin nx upon n minus of 1 minus of cos nx upon n square, limit going from here 0 to pi. See, because next term going to be 0 because this is constant. Next plus 2 pi minus x as it is, then sin nx by n minus 2 pi minus x, 2 pi goes 0, minus x, differentiation of minus x is minus of 1. So minus of 1 minus cos nx upon n square, limit going from pi to 2 pi. Now we have to substitute. Now integration is over, we have to substitute the limit. When we substitute the limit, you see the term for sin equal to 0, sin pi, sin 2 pi, sin 3 pi, all sin goes 0. So no need to substitute the value in sin term. So you have to cut, you have to remove those sin terms. So we no need to put here, no need to put here, we substitute here and here only. Now, next step, when we substitute here, it is 1. So we have to substitute upper and lower both limit. Here also, upper and lower both limit. We substitute here. So when we substitute,
What is our an? 1 upon pi. This minus minus gives plus 1. So plus 1 by n square is coming outside. Cos of n pi minus cos of 0. Cos 0 is 1. So I directly write 1. Minus minus plus 1 plus minus again minus 1 by n square. Same cos of 2n pi minus cos of n pi. 2n pi minus cos of n pi. This we substitute the limits. Next step, simplify it. An is equal to 1 upon pi. And 1 by n square we have to take in total outside. So now what is this? Cos n pi minus 1 minus cos 2n pi plus cos of n pi. This minus minus plus 1. So we know cos n pi is minus 1 to the power n. Cos 2n pi is 1 only. So we substitute the value of cos n pi and cos 2n, 1 upon n square pi. This is 2 cos n pi. So 2 times minus 1 to the power n, minus 1 minus 1, minus of 2. Clear? 2 comes outside. So it gives 2 by n square pi minus 1 to the power n minus 1. This is our an. So we can say it. This is 2 minus of 4 by n square pi and 0. When n is odd. If n is odd, then this gives minus 1 is minus 2. So minus 4 by n pi. N is odd. And if n is even, so see, if n is even, this is plus 1, minus 1 goes 0. So this is our an. An for all n even goes 0, but for all n odd gives this value. Similarly, we have to derive, with same process, we have to derive the bn. When we derive the bn, we can see, when we derive bn is what? This is our an, then bn is equal to 1 upon pi, same 0 to pi, fx is x sin nx plus dx plus pi to 2 pi, 2 pi minus x sin nx dx. This is our bn. Now we have to find out the bn, 1 by pi. Same, integrate x as it is, sin nx is minus cos nx by n minus 1 minus of sin nx upon n square. This limit going from 0 to pi. Next term plus 2 pi minus x. This gives minus cos nx upon n minus 2 pi of going 0, minus x gives minus of 1 minus sin nx upon n square 0, sorry, pi to 2 pi. Its limit is going from pi to 2 pi. So now this is our bn. Next step, we have to substitute the limits. Same, when we want to substitute the limit, we see the sign terms. This is sin and this is sin. We no need to substitute limit in sin terms. It automatically goes 0. Next, cos term. When we cosine term, upper limit pi. When we substitute pi here, it gives the value. Lower limit 0. When we substitute 0 here, so it goes 0. So we have to substitute only upper limit. Same in this case, upper limit 2 pi. So 2 pi minus 2 pi, 0. So upper limit with this term, with upper limit goes 0, but with lower limit gives the value. So we have to substitute here. This is 1 by pi minus of pi by n. Upper limit is cos n pi minus lower limit goes 0. Next we go for this. This is minus, this is 2 pi minus pi is 0. Upper limit is 0 minus of lower limit. Minus minus gives plus. 2 pi minus pi is same. Pi by n cos of n pi. Now see, this is minus pi by n cos pi, this is plus pi by n cos pi. So it cancel out, so our bn comes automatically 0. That is not necessary, bn is always 0 in this case, but in this case our bn is 0. A0 is pi, an is this, bn is equal to 0. You substitute a0, an and bn in given Fourier series, you will get the answer. So what is the our solution for the given equation? Our Fourier series is equal to fx equal to a0 by 2 means pi by 2 plus summation n going from 1 to infinity. Now all even terms are 0 for an. Only odd terms gives value, and if we take minus outside, so it look like 4 by pi cos x by 1 square plus cos 3x by 3 square plus cos 5x upon 5 square and so on. Only odd terms gives the value, even terms goes 0, bn goes 0. So series is this. Now if you want to reduce some series with this, substitute x equal to 0 here. If x equal to 0 we substitute here, then our series will converted into pi square by 8 equal to 1 by 1 square plus 1 by 3 square plus 1 by 5 square and so on. So sometimes they will ask the sum value of that series, sometimes they ask up to there. So this is the Fourier series for discontinuous function. And now next we go for general formula for the Fourier series, or we can say change of interval. Before all Fourier series we discuss only for 0 to 2 pi interval. Either we can say minus pi to plus pi, interval is 2 pi, or 0 to 2 pi, interval is pi, or c to c plus 2 pi, interval is pi on 2 pi. Now we talk about the general term change of interval. If we can say interval is c to c plus 2f, so what is the Fourier series for this general term? Change of interval. Change of interval for this Fourier function. If our c to x to c plus 2l, if our interval is in general case 2l, then what is our Fourier series? For this, our Fourier series fx is given by a0 by 2 plus summation n going from 1 to infinity a n cos n pi x by n plus b n sin n pi x by n. Clear? Means what is the difference? In previous, for 0 to 2 pi interval, your formula is only cos nx sin nx. Here n pi x by n. Actually, this is the general formula. If you substitute, a0 is similarly 1 by, at the place of 1 by pi, this is 1 by n, c to c plus 2n fx dx. An, when we talk about the an for this series is 1 by n, c to c plus 2n fx cos n pi x by n dx. Similarly bn, bn is 1 by l c to c plus 2l fx sin n pi x by l dx. So our a0, an, and bn given by at the place of pi, you replace n, our general term. If you are, so n is anything, any constant, 2, 3, 4. So it is 1 by l, c to c, 2 plus l up to there, a0 l. Now, same for discontinuous function also. If it is discontinuous function, for example, our given function is given for 0 to 2 interval, for 0 to 1, one function f1, and 1 to 2, other function f2. So you have to break it from 0 to 1, fx cos n pi x by l. Then from 1 to 2, other function, and you substitute and integrate it. So this is the Fourier series for general interval. In very short, I give one example in this, so you can better understand how to solve this. Then we go for the half range series. So question, find a Fourier series for fx equal to x square minus 2, interval is minus 2 to plus 2. See, minus l to plus l. So when interval is minus negative same value to positive, means minus pi to plus pi, minus l to plus l, and this thing, then we check for either, if we can able to check this is even or odd, we can deduce some terms. If we can't able to say, if it is exponential function, we can't, we find out all the terms a0. So in that case, this function is even function, because x square gives always positive value. So this is even function. F of x is equal to f of minus x. So for even function, Fourier series is, we have to find out a0 and an. Bn goes 0. So its bn is, if you find out, it automatically 0. You have to, no need to find out. Now we find out a0 and an. So what is our Fourier series? Fx, or we can say x square minus 2, is given by a0 by 2 plus summation n going from 1 to infinity an cos n pi x by n. L is 2. So our series is cos pi n x by 2. Now what is a0? A0 is 1 by n. Now minus 2 plus. So minus L to plus L, if it is even function, so it is 0, 2 times 0 to L. So 2 times 0 to 2 and 1 2 comes outside. So 2 times 0 to 2, fx is x square minus 2 dx. When you solve it, you will get a0 equal to minus of 4 by 3. Integrate. Next, we go for an. When we talk about the an, an is equal to say 2, 1 by 2, 1 by l, then 2 times 0 to l, l is 2, fx is x square minus 2 cos n pi x by 2 dx, n pi x by l dx. So we have to integrate it. Say 2 by 2 is 1, so this gives x square minus 2 cos n pi x gives sin n pi x by 2 upon n pi by 2. Clear? Next, minus x square gives 2x minus of cos n pi x by 2, and variable of this is n square pi square by 4. Plus, variable of minus 2x is minus 2 minus sin n pi x by 2 upon, one more time, n cube pi cube upon a 2 to the power 3. Limit going from minus 0 to 2. Clear? So this is our an. Now we have to substitute the limits. So when we go talk about the limits, say sin, remove, because see, when we substitute here x equal to 2, then n pi 2 by 2 cancel, so sine n pi is 0 and x is 0, sine 0 is also 0 similarly. So we remove sine terms always, only substitute in cos term. Similarly, when we substitute upper limit x equal to 2, it will give us the value. When substitute x equal to 0, it goes 0. So we have to substitute only and only the upper limit in this term. So when we substitute upper limit, it gives minus 2, x is 2, minus and n square pi square by 4 outside, then minus cos n pi x is 2 by 2. So it is only cos n pi by 2. So what is our an? An is very simple. It is minus 4, this 4 also comes up, upon n square pi square minus 1 to the power n, cos n pi is. So this is 16. So minus of 16 upon n square pi square minus 1 to the power n. This is your an, you have to substitute a0 and an in the series, you will get the required Fourier series. So that is Fourier series for general interval, not in terms of pi. If it is not in terms of pi, you have to write cos n pi x by n. N is your limit. What is your limit? Next we go for Fourier series, half range Fourier series. Half range Fourier series is if our total interval is 2 pi, the given the series data in 0 to pi interval. So we have to expand this interval up to negative side also, and then we have to find out the Fourier series, that is half range. Means total interval is, difference is 2 pi, they give only for pi, or in general term they give only 0 to n interval. So half range series are little bit similar to even and odd series. When we talk about the half range series, you can see that it is similar, seems to be even and odd, but you have to remember always what are the half range series. So I can discuss half range series in my next video. Thank you very much.